Secondly, Madam President, I would like to address the issue of the impeachment trial, which the Senate Majority Leader, Senator McConnell, raised this morning. Before I was elected to Congress, I made a living as a lawyer and took many cases to trial. Few, if any, ever moved to a final decision without the introduction of evidence. The evidence, of course, consists of documentation, sometimes physical evidence, but often the testimony of people who were witnesses to events critical to a jury's final decision. This impeachment trial should be nothing less. This is an opportunity for us, a rare opportunity in American history, to come forward and to demonstrate that we are going to handle a trial in the United States Senate in a professional manner. For the Senate Majority Leader, Senator McConnell, to announce there will be no witnesses, there will be no evidence, there will be no documents in advance, is to deny the very basis of a trial, as I understand it, and most Americans understand it. If this president believes, as he said so often, that the charges in the impeachment articles do not rise to any serious or credible level, then certainly there's evidence that could prove his case. He will have his managers on the floor of the Senate when the articles are presented to us. They can certainly call witnesses. They can bring evidence before us. But so far, the record is not very strong for that to happen. One of the articles of impeachment, the second one, relates to the president's refusal to cooperate with the investigation in the House, refusal to provide documentation and witnesses. For a president who's arguing there's really nothing to these charges, he has refused to provide even the most basic evidence to prove his point, if it exists. What we are saying on the Democratic side is if there's to be a trial for impeachment in the United States Senate, common sense and the Constitution require that it be a fair trial with evidence for not only the senators but the American people to see themselves. What we have asked so far is limited in terms of what we are looking for. Four witnesses and documents that can be clearly identified. Those are things which I think should be part of this trial record, so that regardless of the outcome of the trial, the American people believe that it was handled fairly in a dispassionate and nonpartisan way.